friends. Today I'm back with another Two Pros and a Con review. Two Pros and a Con is a feature that I came up with to allow me to do something between a book talk and a book review. Pretty self-explanatory, I will tell you two positive things and one negative thing about the book. And today I'm reviewing Fuzzy Nation by John Scalzi. This was a total because of BookTube read. I had read some Scalzi before, and I was hesitant to continue, though I had put some stuff on my TBR for a future date, but I saw a few people talking about Fuzzy Nation across BookTube, and I picked it up. Otherwise, can we talk about this cover and how I would probably never have picked that up otherwise? It really doesn't grab the attention, but I was super pleasantly surprised. Fuzzy Nation is set in the future where humans and corporations have traveled into space and are exploiting the natural resources of other planets, though there are some rules and regulations in place, specifically that the planet cannot have sentient life. Jack Holloway is our main character, and he's a disbarred lawyer who is now working as a prospector and surveyor for Zarakorp. Jack lucks into finding a very valuable seam of jewels, and while that poses some problems for him in and of itself, things get more complicated when a very adorable creature shows up at Jack's house with his family in tow. They are smart and they are cute, but the question is, are they people? My first pro is that Jack Holloway is a really great main character. I am not a fan of anti-heroes. I feel like my meh reaction to them really came as a way of blogging and having to repeatedly hear people defend anti-heroes' gross behavior. I'm talking about Spike again because I always talk about Spike and how he ruined me, but that entire experience of where anti-heroes do really awful things and sometimes we excuse those things, that kind of soured me on the idea of the anti-hero, so I always put my guard up when it comes to them. But Jack really was a great jerk character. He is a jerk, to be sure, but he's more self-interested than morally ambiguous. In the end, it's his self-interest that drives everything else, not that he's just a straight, like, bad dude, but that he is in it for himself. It's expressed in very understandable ways, like he does things for himself where you're like, that sucked, but I get it. He's also just very smart, resourceful, and he doesn't always get it right, but half the fun is seeing him work it out and seeing the plan kind of come to life the way that Jack envisions it and how he sets all of the pieces into motion. My second pro is that the writing was just super great for this very strange setup. It's very reined in and unsentimental, and Jack's no-nonsense, a lawyer personality really shines through the writing, but it still manages to be very engaging. I think that this book could have run the risk of going too saccharine and just really pitching the cuteness of the creatures of the fuzzies, but it didn't do that. It let you fall in love with the fuzzies yourself, and you really got an idea of how smart and adorable they were without the prose hammering it in. For this to work, you really needed Jack to be kind of distant from the whole fuzzy aspect of it, which he was to a certain degree. Jack is also very sarcastic and witty, and surprise surprise, I love those kind of characters as well, so that wit really came through the writing and I enjoyed it a lot. My one con is that Scalzi has this specific method that he uses to create suspense. Jack would go through a scene and he would see something or realize something, but we wouldn't know what it was. Or we would cut away without realizing that he realized something, only to later have him reference that moment and say, yes, because during that moment, I came to this conclusion. It's a little bit difficult to explain, but for example, there is a scene, which this is not spoilery, but there is a scene where Jack has run low on groceries, so he's decided to feed the fuzzies bacon, and the fuzzies freaking fall in love with bacon, so he's feeding the fuzzies and his dogs bacon. Everyone's interacting, the dog is begging for bacon, the fuzzies are interacting with the dog, and Jack is feeding the fuzzies, and then the scene ends. Later, Jack is talking about the fuzzies and he's made a huge discovery about them, and it happened in the bacon scene when all that happened that we saw was just Jack feeding them bacon. He gives no sign at that moment that he's made the discovery or that anything this big has even happened. It just felt kind of manufactured and cheap. We saw the scene one way, only to have that main character tell us later that something else happened at that moment for him. It's very, and then I realized something, end scene. It's just not my favorite tool or device. Obviously, it didn't affect the story that much because I still gave it a 4.5 out of 5 stars. The ending was a little bit too neat for me. Everything fell into place, and there's even an epilogue blog where people kind of walk around and say, hey you, with your updates and your new title and your life going on, just in very wooden language so you know what everybody is doing. That felt a little bit too neat for me, but if you're a person who likes very resolved endings, this would be another reason to pick up this book. Overall, I really enjoyed this book. It was very entertaining. I think about it and I smile because of the good time I had while I was reading it. So that's it, my very quick two pros and a con on Fuzzy Nation by John Scalzi. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I will see you guys soon. And this allows me to, you know, karate chop, apparently.